Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Gunpla quick fix video. Here we're talking about the recently released Master Grade Wing Gundam Zero EW Verka kit and this massive sea mine that it's got on its back wings. Now it's a really great kit, really fantastic kit that won all overall, but you know, back here on this back wing you've got this big massive sea mine going all the way down and around there, so it's going to be a bit of a problem. It's on the back, not really all that noticeable, but if you do want to get rid of it, I'll just show you how I'm going to go about doing this. Now, of course, the problem is going to be that once we seal up this seam line, then you're sealing in these couple of parts over here, the gray part and then this moving part of the wing here are going to be sealed inside, so you need to think about that. Now, of course, you could just go about that and just seal this all up and then just paint this all as it is. This part up here, you would have to mask that, and that wouldn't be all really necessarily that difficult, but I don't really feel like I want to mask that, so I want to be able to remove that and just paint it separately. So if we take a look at the parts separated here, you can see basically what I'm going to do for this is what I've done before. That just fits onto that peg like that. So you guys have seen me do this before with this kind of joints. Basically just going to cut out the little section of that so that it just makes a C kind of clip joint. And then that'll be able to just pop onto the peg there like that instead of actually feeding onto the peg like normal. So that should be pretty simple. Now the problem that I think we might run into is that it might not be able to hold up the wing as well, because once you do this it does kind of make the joint not quite as tight, so we might have to end up tightening that up a little bit. It's not that big of a deal, but just something to keep in mind, and we'll test it out just to see how tight the fit is once the modification is done. As for this lower bit of wings in here, I'm just going to seal these in. I'm not going to make it so that these are removable or anything like that, because these can just be painted together with the full wing. I can extend that out and paint these parts just fine with them being in there. So this I'm going to leave in there like that. You could modify that, I'm sure, in some different ways, be able to take those parts out and paint them separately by putting some glue around there, or just like cutting the main wing part apart or something. But for me, I'm just going to leave those in there for this modification. But what you are going to want to do before you get to spraying all your paint on this is sand these parts ahead of time, because once you got this all sealed up, it's going to be a little bit hard to sand these parts. So if you're doing your sanding before your paint, you're going to want to sand these before you seal them in there. It just make them probably a little bit easier. Otherwise, your life would be a little bit harder. So let me just mark it out to show you guys very clearly. Here is where I'm thinking we're going to cut. So we're going to cut out this section of this where it's thin, and also it's a part that obviously won't show at all once the part is all put back together. So there you go, that's how it's going to look once that's all cut out and cleaned up. Now once you push this on there, it's going to put some pressure on that, and because that's so thin there at the top, you're going to want to be a little bit careful, because it could break off if you're not too careful with it. So it needs to be big enough that it'll fit onto there without putting too much pressure on that top bit, but you know, tight enough that you still got a good fit onto the peg. Otherwise it's going to be completely loose. Now we'll see just how loose this ends up being here. Well, it looks like it's going to be loose, that the wing is going to be falling down, so I may have cut that just a little bit too big, or just this wing part is also going to be heavy, so it should be able to stay up like that, and this one is not staying up. Now, not that big a deal, no need to freak out, because we can tighten that joint up a little bit more, or just glue it. Once mine is all actually put together, I don't like to keep mine posed at all, so this is actually just going to be glued ultimately anyway, or it can be if I need it to be, and it looks like I am probably going to need to glue that, But all right, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. For now, let's just get to removing this seam. Now, I'm going to do it one way, but a lot of people say to remove your seam lines by laying your glue around the edge on one side and then around the other edge on the other side and then putting them together. But I hardly ever do it that way. I usually do it more like this, putting the pieces together ahead of time like that, leaving just a tiny little bit of gap in between. And that is because what I find is usually when you have the two pieces separately, so you lay your gluing all around on one side and then you have to go over it again, just because it's already starting to dry, so you might have to go over it a couple times to get a good layer of wet glue on there before you put them together. But if you have a really long seam on like this, you're going to find that the glue is going to be drying quite a bit before you actually get it actually stuck together. And it's not completely cured or anything, but if you do it like this, leaving just a tiny little bit of gap in there, it's going to be much easier. You can get the glue in there and it won't be drying really quite as fast because it's got less contact with the air. So you're just laying your glue right in there into the line, and it'll act like a vein and the glue will just seep through there and have much better coverage, and it won't get so dry in there. Now we are, of course, also going to want to be careful of any moving parts inside. Now for this one, I've got this moving part in there that I want to still be able to move. So we want to be careful when I'm putting in the glue in there that I'm not just splashing loads of glue in there, that it's going to be getting everywhere inside and then getting into the moving mechanism that I don't want to be stuck up with glue. So I'm usually pretty liberal in my glue application here for C-mine removal, because usually you want to have a little bit more than not enough. That's always better, but in this case I had to be especially careful around the section where that moving part is. I don't want to have too much glue going into that. Even with this system being better for the glue drying, I'll still usually go over the entire seam line twice with the glue. Like I said, I like to be pretty liberal with it. And then once we pop that together, you get a good amount of glue coming out. That's always better. If you have a little bit of glue coming out, that's actually exactly what you want, to have a little bead of wet glue just poking out once you press the parts together there. So that is the ideal thing that you want to see. Now again, just in case I might have gotten some glue into where I don't want it for this particular part, once this is actually starting to dry, I'll just keep moving this back and forth, and not continuously, but like I'll just move it back and forth every now and then, just to make sure that if some glue did get in there into where I don't want it to go, that it will not really get stuck to anything. So now all we really need to do is just give that some time to cure, then we can come back and get to sanding it. All right, after some waiting and then some filing and some sanding, that is all completely gone now. I'll have to see once the primer is on there, I'll be able to tell, you know, if that's totally gone. I might have to go back in and do a little bit more sanding or something. May have to do a little bit of putty and or super glue on some little bits that may have been missed, but it seems pretty good. Sanding it and taking a look, it seems pretty smooth. Now it's white, so it's gonna be hard for you guys to see, but you know, and that's the thing, it's hard for me to see as well too. That's why primer is so important, to find any defaults. But for now, it's looking pretty good, and we're ready to go get into painting once I got the rest of the kit all sanded and prepped up. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully this little tip was helpful for you guys. I know it's a pretty easy little fix, but just in case it wasn't very obvious to anyone out there, I hope that this video was helpful for some of you. So again, I'll just remind you guys to check out the kit and everything else there on USA Gundam Store. The link will be down below. You can use my coupon code there as well too, Zacharelius10, to save 10% off everything in the store. Thank you so much to USA Gundam Store for their support, and thank you to you guys as well for watching, and hope you're all having a great day. I'll see you guys later. Bye bye.